morning, East Queen Street.
Good morning.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. As we come again this morning to have worship, we're going to ask the praise team to begin for us by singing, "Bless the Lord, God Almighty and Majesty."
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise
the Lord, everybody. We have come into his house, gathered in his name to worship him. Our God in heaven is a great and gracious God. So as we center ourselves for praise and worship this morning, let's lift hearts, voices, and minds upward, hands even. But let us gather and agree in one that our God is worthy of our praise. Blessed be the Lord God Almighty.
Come glorify. shout of praise this morning. Give the Lord a shout of praise. Worship his majesty. Just take a few seconds to just worship his majesty. He is worthy. He is worthy. He is King of Kings. He is Lord of Lords. He is the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. He is worthy. El Shaddai, El Elyon, Adonai, Yahweh, Yeshua HaMashiach. We worship you, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Rapha. He heals our diseases. Hallelujah. He's the peace in the midst of the storm. Jehovah Shalom. We worship him this morning. We worship his majesty. He is worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Command your souls to praise him this morning. Command your spirits to praise him this morning. No rock is going to cry out in our place. No trees are going to cry out in our place. We worship his majesty. Hallelujah. The anointing breaks the yoke. And we declare this morning that every yoke is broken. Hallelujah. 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 We declare his majesty. We declare his majesty.
Hallelujah.
Jesus who died, now glorified, King of all kings, Lord of all lords. Hallelujah.
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 Bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. As we continue to worship, may I just take time out to say a special good morning to those persons who are visiting with us today and those persons who are online. Whatever platform you choose this morning, the blessings of the Lord be with you. Blessed be the Lord God Almighty, who reigns forevermore. And if there's someone who is joining in with us this morning and have not accepted the Lord as your Savior, I am inviting you to do so before it is too late. God bless you. God bless you. We now go into the call to worship. God of infinite blessings, you touch our lives with love, joy, and peace. We come to this place today ready to hear your voice working through us, ready to celebrate your spirit among us, and ready to be open to your grace. Gracious God, in your Son, Jesus Christ, we have blessed us with every good gift, justice, joy, and daily bread. Turn us into beacons of love, generosity, and righteousness, that we may be emboldened to serve you. We are here to worship. We acknowledge that God's gifts surround us in all stages of our lives. Hence, we trust you for what we need as we bring our prayers and praises to you. Open our hearts, eyes, and ears for us to worship you. Lord, everywhere we look, we see the imprint of your creative love. Your wondrous work in nature shows your majesty and power. As we gather to celebrate your love and creation, prepare us to work for you in ministries of peace and justice. Forgive our overwhelming greed and selfishness, and bring us into your glory. Amen. Amen. Hymn of Approach. Joyful, joyful, we adore thee.
Joyful, joyful, we adore thee.
Let us pray. Teach us how to love each other. Lift us to the joy divine. Almighty God, we come before your throne another time. This morning we give you all the glory and we give you all the praise. Because our praises belongs to you. And Lord, we all you desire of us is for us to serve you, to worship you in the beauty of holiness. So this morning we thank you for this wonderful privilege. We thank you, God, for enabling us to be here today. As there are some persons who do not have this privilege. Some persons would want to come and they cannot. But Lord, we thank you. And we are not taking the blessings for granted, because oftentimes we do that. But we know that you are our great I am. You are our rose of Sharon. You are the lily of the valley. And you are bright as morning star. So this morning I lift your name and I love to sing your praises. You came from heaven to earth to show the way. And so this morning we thank you, because you are the way, the truth, and the life. This morning we adore you. And even though we come this morning, there are times when some little things got in the way. There are some things that we need to make right with you. But God, we know that a broken and a contrite heart you will not despise. So we come to tell you, oh wretched we are. We come to tell you that we are sinful. And if we say that we have no sin, then we make you the liar and the truth is not in us. But this morning, we thank you, because we know that we have access to the throne of grace. That when we sin, Lord, we can come before you to ask forgiveness. And we know that, God, you will do so. I pray this morning that you will bless us, bless this church, dear God. As I put it before you right now, God, I pray for your blessings. I pray that, God, you will move among us this morning. As you move on the day of Pentecost, when the people were together on one accord, when we are in the oneness of mind and spirit, then, God, you will send your anointing from above. So this morning I pray for the anointing. Not only that I pray for the anointing, God, but I pray for the anointing in a double portion this morning. Because without you, anointing, God, we cannot make it. Because without you, Lord, we are not able to go on. But I pray this morning for courage. I pray for strength. As the songwriter said, courage, brother, do not stumble. Though the path be dark as night, but there is a star. We know that, God, you are the star, and you are able to lead the humble if we only trust in you and do the right. I pray this morning that, God, you just remember us in your mercies. There are so many petitions we have this morning. People are sick and afflicted, but we know that you are the great doctor of all doctors, so we put them before you this morning. People are in need, Lord, and we know that you are Jehovah Jireh, so we put them before you this morning. I know that, God, the children are to go back to school. It's a difficult task, God, because things are hard, but you are the great provider, so we put it before you, dear God. The Ministry of Education, the teachers, God, you see the situation in the Ministry of Education and the teachers leaving, but you are God and you are provider, you are a way maker, so we put these children, God, before your hands, in your hands this morning. We pray that you will have your blessed sweet way. We pray, oh God, for those persons listening to us this morning, that you will bless them in a special way. We pray, God, for your leading this morning. Lead, God, and let us follow. And if you lead, then we will go the way we ought to go. I pray that you remember us. Bless this service. Every activity that is to be done here today, I put it in your hands. I pray for the preacher who will bring the word. Oh, God, a special anointing. Hallelujah. From the crown of his head, even, oh God, to the soles of his feet. And as he speaks this morning, I pray, dear God, as the word go forth, then the word will do what is to be done. I pray that you will have your blessed sweet way. Bless us individually and bless us collectively now. As I submit this service, I submit every care in your hand, and I tell you thanks now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We say hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus. Jesus. Hallelujah.
Father God in heaven, Lord Most High, hear your children's prayer, Lord Most High.
Responsive psalm comes to us from Psalm 46. I'm going to ask you to stand as we read alternately. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.
Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea.
Though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof.
There is a river, the streams thereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High.
God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early.
He then raged, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
Come, behold the works of the Lord. What desolations he hath made in the earth.
He maketh wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow, and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire.
Be still, and I know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Of praise. Holy, holy, holy.
Come on, let's put our hands together as we sing. Holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty.
Holy, 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 holy.
Hallelujah. Let's bless a worthy God.
Hallelujah.
Let's bless a holy God.
Hallelujah.
Let's bless a good, good, gracious God.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Worthy. Hallelujah. Worthy God.
Hallelujah. The Lord's name is worthy. Worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the Lord's name is worthy. Can I hear a amen to that? The Lord's name is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. At this time, we go into fellowship and worship, and we'll be having the announcement. Somebody from the secretariat will be coming with the announcement this morning.
Good morning, brothers and sisters.
Good morning.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in Him. We thank God for the privilege of allowing us to come into His presence this first day in September 2022. We are here at East Queen Street Baptist Church, 25 East Queen Street, Kingston, Jamaica, to worship, to continue to worship, and to give God all the praise and glory. Amen?
Amen.
Later in the service, we will gather at the Lord's table for Holy Communion. And as we worship, it is our prayer that we will be drawn closer to God. And if there's anyone among us who has not yet accepted Him as their Lord and Savior, we pray that they seize this opportunity to do it today. Leading our service this morning is Deacon Claudine Bowen and the preacher, Reverend Devere Nugent. The worship and enhancement team, we have Mr. Orain Shaw, the praise team, and the youth choir. We are also supported by our media, usher, and hospitality teams. We pray that the Lord will have His way in and through His servants, so we will experience His presence in this time of worship. Welcome to our pastor, Reverend Devere Nugent, from his vacation, and all the persons in the sanctuary and those online this morning. We want to welcome Mistress Maiseline Dalberry. She is the widow of Mr. Carnell Dalberry, who is also the niece of Denise Bryan. Oh, I am so sorry. The uncle of Denise Bryan and Neil Dalberry. Well, it's Noel Dalberry. Mistress Dalberry, just give us a wave. Welcome, welcome. We also want to welcome Sister Cynthia Lee, who is with us this morning. Welcome, Sister Lee. Good to see you. And also Miss Gloria Lewis and family. Will you stand, please? Sister Lewis celebrated her 91st birthday. Wow. Hallelujah. Good to see you. An extra special welcome if you're joining us for the first time in the sanctuary and online. Do we have any visitors? Well, we're all family here. Welcome, welcome. If you do not have a church home of your own, we invite you to become a part of the East Queen Street family. And you may reach us on our Facebook page. You may also email us at equester25@yahoo.com. Or you may reach us through our prayer line. which is open from Monday to Friday between the hours of 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. And the telephone number is 876-948-251. We go now to sympathy. But let me just read a thank you card from Sister Grayson to the senior choir and members of the church family, my family. And I would like to thank you all for your support in prayers, telephone calls, and encouraging words that were shared. This helped us to cope during our time of bereavement. May the Lord continue to bless you all. From Sister Grayson and family. We ask that you continue to pray for our sick and shut-in members. The names are listed on pages 14 and 15 of the bulletin. Remember also those among us who are mourning the loss of loved ones. As a church family, we express our sincere condolences to Deacon Hilton Farquharson on the passing of his brother, Mr. Donald Farquharson, Sister Inez Sparks on the death of her husband, and Sister Khadisha Perry on the death of her brother. The funeral service for Mr. Carnell Dalberry, uncle of Sister Denise Bryan and Brother Noel Dalberry, will be held on Friday, September 16, 2022 at 10:30 a.m. at the Boulevard Baptist Church. May the God of comfort grant these families strength in their time of bereavement. We go now to congratulations. Congratulations to everyone celebrating birthdays, anniversaries, and other milestones this week. We give God thanks and pray his continued blessing on their lives. On our birthday list this week, today, September 4th, we have Brother Gregory Martin. September 6th, Brother Delroy Brown. Leroy Brown. September 8th, Sister Merlin McKenzie. September 9th, Brother Kenneth East, Sister Adele Bell, and Brother Matthew Dean, who is overseas. Anyone celebrating this week? And if your name, please stand. Sister Diana Martin, or Sister Meredith, may we have the birthday song? Birthday, the joy of the Lord be yours, and we pray that his peace, the peace of God, cover you as you celebrate a new year of your life. We go now to crusade, the crusade for 2022. Bear in mind these dates and add this to your prayer list, the preparation of the crusade to your prayer list as well. The theme this year is Come Experience New Life in Christ. Crusade starts on Sunday, September 18, and will end on Sunday, September 25. Meetings will be held. The first three nights will be in the communities, and the other four here on the church ground. September 18, which is the first night, will be at the corner of James and Sutton Street. The second evening on the 19th and the 20th will be at Gold Street. Meeting will start at 6 p.m. The preachers are Deacon Kenesha Fowler Henry of Delacree Park Baptist Church, Reverend Franklin Small of Hanover Street Circuit, and Reverend Devere Nugent of the East Queen Street Circuit of Churches. This year, the Hanover Street Baptist Church is celebrating 200 years. They are inviting us to join them on Sunday, September 18, 2022 at 9:30 a.m. for a special Thanksgiving service. Please remember this date in mind and support them if you can. In preparation for harvest in November 22, we are asking the gardeners among us to nurture a houseplant or two and to take to the sanctuary on the Saturday before harvest Sunday. Interested persons may speak to Sister Delane McFarlane. We are almost at the end of the church year. As such, we need to put plans in place for the coming year. Secretaries of the committees and auxiliaries are asked to submit their 2021 to 2022 reports to the secretariat as soon as possible. Please collect report forms from Sister Bevelyn Brown. Thanks to the Healing and Counseling Ministry team for organizing the Back to School Blist last Sunday. Our church is particularly grateful to the presenters from the National Council of Drug Abuse, the Mental Health Unit, and the Nutrition Unit of the Ministry of Health, and to Grace Kennedy for their donations. We pray God's blessing on them as they work to educate our students on these matters. These are the notices. The next act is worship through giving. I invite the ushers to come forward and to wait on you to collect your offerings. Deacon Irvin Sutherland will bless our offerings. But just a reminder, the methods available for giving are online to the East Queen Street Baptist Church, National Commercial Bank, which is at New Kingston, checking account number 211-636-998, or call the church office to make other arrangements. Have a blessed week.
Gracious God, we acknowledge your unstoppable and unending provisions for us throughout our lives. And as an act of worship, we bring to you our tithes and our offerings. We do so willingly and not grudgingly, because we know that you love a cheerful giver. So help us to give so that it will be given to us. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you.
Bible readings are as follows. Proverbs chapter 3, reading from verse 1 to 10, and this will be read by Deacon Isind Knight. Then 2 Corinthians 9, 1 to 10, this will be read by Deacon Christopher Brown. St. Luke chapter 19, 1 to 10, and this will be read by yours truly. We'll now have Hymn of Meditation, Speak, O Lord.
Lesson comes to us from the book of Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 1 to 10. My son, forget not my law, but let thine heart keep my commandments. For length of days and long life and peace shall they add to thee. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about thy neck. Write them upon the table of thine heart. So shalt thou find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and man. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not on thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord, and depart from evil. It shall be health to thy navel, and marrow to thy bones. Honor the Lord with thy substance, and with the first fruits of all thine increase. So shall thy barns be filled with plenty, and thy presses shall burst out with new wine. This is the word of the Lord.
Good morning, brethren. Second reading will be taken from the second book of Corinthians, chapter 9, reading from verse 1 straight to verse 10. And it reads, "There is no need for me to write to you about this service to the Lord's people, for I know your eagerness to help, and I have been boasting about it to the Macedonians, telling them that since last year, you in Achaia were ready to give, and your enthusiasm has stirred most of them to action. But I am sending the brothers in order that our boasting about you in this matter should not prove hollow, but that you may be ready, as I said you would be. For if any Macedonians come with me and find you unprepared, we, not to say anything about you, would be ashamed of having been so confident. So I thought it necessary to urge the brothers to visit you in advance and finish the arrangements for the generous gift you had promised. Then it will be ready as a generous gift, not as one grudgingly given. Remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work, as it is written. Freely they have scattered their gifts to the poor, their righteousness endures forever. Now he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will also supply and increase your store of seed, and will enlarge the harvest of your righteousness. This is the word of the Lord.
Reading St. Luke chapter 19, reading from verse 1 to 10. And Jesus entered and passed through Jericho. And behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus, which was a chief among the publicans, and he was rich. And he sought to see Jesus, who he was, and could not for the press, because he was little of stature. And he ran before and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and saw him, and said unto him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for today I must abide at thy house. And he made haste and came down and received him joyfully. And when they saw it, they all murmured, saying that he was gone to be guest with a man that is a sinner. And Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor, and if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I restore him fourfold. And Jesus
said unto him, This day is salvation come to this house, for so much as he also is the son of Abraham. Verse 10, for the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost, the gospel. Thanks be to God. We'll now have a special item of music by the senior choir. And after the senior choir, you'll be hearing from the man of God, our own pastor, Reverend DeVere Nugent.
Sisters and brothers, as the choir comes to you this morning, we are very mindful that life as it goes on and on comes with its fair share of challenges and stresses and distresses. And we are not at all hidden from the terror and the horror. But we have a God who has assured us that he will be with us. We have a God who will still the storms. But we know that if he doesn't still the storms, he will keep us in the storm. Amen. And the word of God reminds us that wherever we are, don't be afraid. Fear not. Isaiah 41, verse 10. I will strengthen you. I am your God. I will uphold you. I will hold you. I will keep you with the right hand of my righteousness. God is able to keep us and to hold us.
Yes.
The choir.
Still my soul, the Lord is on my side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Lift to thy God to order and provide.
Those he saves are his dear.
And the church of God say amen.
Amen.
For my Savior loves me so, I'm convinced he will hold me fast. I suspect that applause was for me, so I thank you. But if you know it is for the Lord, then we can do better than that. It is a special song for a special church at a special time. And I want to ask your permission just to indicate how special we are to God. Last week, Wednesday, Deacon Humes celebrated his 16th birthday, and he didn't tell us. Oh, he wants to correct me. He says his 71st birthday. And as you know, could you just stand, Deacon Humes? Deacon Humes is the chairman of the Deacon's Board here. God bless you, sir. God bless you. Trust you had a good day. We'll make it up. How blessed we are. There were some other persons who celebrated birthday last week. And one of them has led a battalion of persons to church. In the person of Sister Lewis. Sister Gloria celebrates 91 years. Come on, church, give God praise. For the word says, he will hold me fast. If you could bring me into the monitors, I think I'm hearing myself in the house. And then on Friday of last week, we celebrated with Sister Hopkins, her 102nd birthday. And can I tell you, at 102, her memory is better than the pastor's. She is as sharp as they come. And I believe that the words that the choir reminded us this morning, that God in his eternal wisdom will hold us fast. To the children and grandchildren and other family members of Sister Lewis, thank you for choosing East Green Street as the point of worship this morning. I look forward to meeting all of you because I am told I am officially a part of the family. And who vex a fitting business, they can't get rid of me. Good to see you, good to have you. Let me also say, having not preached for a few weeks, I might not be as sharp as the choir is, so you will forgive me. I have to work my way back to preaching. Amen? At least some people are in agreement with me. Our passage for reflection today are two of the most popular verses in Scripture. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and verse 6. When you have found it, say amen. Trust the Lord with all your heart. lean not to your own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Can we say that one more time? Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him. Trust the one who can save. Trust the one who can save. Let us pray. I am listening, Lord, for thee. What hast thou to say to me? Speak to me by name, O Master, and let me know it is to me. Speak that I may follow faster, with a step more firm and free, that the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts together will be accepted in your sight, O God, for you are my strength and our Redeemer. And the church say,
amen.
The church say,
amen.
A few weeks ago, the pastoral team, regardless of the denominational boundaries we hold, woke up to some shocking news. One of our colleague pastor and his family lost two sons in one day. And if you can feel that from where I am, you can imagine those other pastors like myself with sons. But last week we woke up to the frightening news that a mother and her daughters were at the river in St. Mary, and two girls were washed away. These are not acts of crime and violence. Apparently, had it been crime and violence, we would say, oh, the devil. But these are incidents and accidents that have just rocked our boats as human beings. And the question that has challenged me, giving thought to it, is how do we navigate life when life is so hard? How do we navigate life when life is just downright challenging and out difficult? I suspect that one of the reasons some of you are here is because you are not facing any such existential crises. So life for you might not be as hard and challenging and or difficult as for some other people. But Sister Lois said that over her 91 years, what she has learned about life is that yes, life is hard, life is challenging, and life is difficult, but we must face life with two things: courage and wisdom. Preach to yourself now, Pastor. This church is just quiet. We must embrace life with courage and with wisdom. In fact, it is the second of the two things that Sister Louis said we must face life with that commands our attention today: wisdom. Because wisdom becomes a way of thinking, a way of training, and a way of living. One more time, wisdom becomes a way of thinking, a way of training, and a way of living. It therefore suggests that it is through wisdom and with wisdom we can mediate, we can moderate, and we can manipulate the hard, challenging, and difficulties we find in life. Again, my church has gone quiet on me, so let me speak to myself and encourage myself in the pulpit. Let me go one more time to say that in order to mediate, in order to moderate, and in order to manipulate the hardships, the difficulties, and the challenges we encounter, wisdom is needed. In fact, I'm not a wisdom literature scholar, but Proverbs forms the basis of the literature. And if Sister Nugent would be so kind as to help us with chapter 1 and verse number 7. If she would be so kind to help us with chapter 1 and verse number 7. Let's hear what the writer says in chapter 1 and verse number 7. Are we ready now, church? For the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. Can we hear what he had to say in chapter 3 and verse number 7? In chapter 3 and number 7. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. One more. What did he say in chapter 9, verse 10? Chapter 9, verse 10. Bear with me, church, we're coming. Are we ready now? For the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the holy is understanding. The reality then, churches, can we go back to where we started? How do we manipulate? How do we mediate? And how do we moderate these times? Wisdom. But the wisdom that we are talking about is not something that you have gained from your first class degree at the university. It is not something you have gained by your 10 CXCs. Nor is it something that you attained by holding the highest and or the best offices.
The truth of the matter is, there are still some people with good degrees. They have first-class honors, big-time masters, and big-time PhDs, but yet still, wisdom is elusive. There are those who have big jobs, drive big cars, and live in big houses, but wisdom is still elusive. There are those whose bank managers know them by name and by their account, but wisdom is still elusive. It is elusive because the fear of God is not an accompaniment, nor is it accompanying their lives. Oh Lord, church. So it doesn't matter then how much education you have. It doesn't matter how much money you have. It doesn't even matter the quality of your job. What it says to me is this: if you don't start at the point where God is the holder of your life, you are still unwise. I gotta go. Let's go. Chapter 3 of our passage, church. Chapter 3 of our passage in its length comes under three main EGs. Three major themes are located in chapter 3. Can we take them one at a time? Not going to preach them, but are you ready, church? What are the themes emanating from chapter 3? And over the month, we will negotiate some of them in Bible studies. One theme is trust, total trust. Are you with me, church? Two, total obedience. And three, total submission. Run that again. Chapter 3 walks us through total trust, total obedience, and total submission. It therefore suggests that the one who experiences and the one who demonstrates wisdom in God is the one who lives his or her life how? In total trust to God. Come on, Parson. In total trust to God. In total obedience. And in total submission. Let's take it one more time because this church is sleeping. Total trust. Total obedience and total submission. I can't reach this entire passage, church, but I would want to hasten to say that if you are living for God, then you must live in wisdom. And anyone who lives in God and godly wisdom lives in total trust, total obedience, and total submission to God. We will come back to that. Let me just prevent myself here. Chapter 3. Sister Nugent, if you could bring up verse 1 for me. We soon preach and get out of your way. It's a conversation between a father and a son. My son, forget not my laws, but let thine heart keep my commandments. One of the responsibility of a Jewish father was to teach his son not just the Torah, but to teach him how to grow in wisdom. Hello, church? In other words, those two words, and I can't preach them this morning, my son. You recall what I said to you of what chapter 3 does? Eh? My son, my task is to help you to live in total trust. Preach not, pastor. To live in total obedience and to live in total submission to the Almighty God. Oh, Lord, church, let me preach it now. Sister Brown, can I preach it now? When I read it, church, and I saw it, I had to go back to God in confession. I had to say, God, I wonder if you were to weigh me against this particular matrix, would I be standing tall? Am I in a position to speak to other men about what we should do for our young men? Am I, as a father of 3 boys, in the category to speak boldly that as I lead my life, not as a pastor, not as a public servant, but as a father, have I yet translated to my sons that in order to navigate the course of life, you must live in wisdom to the Almighty God. And this wisdom says you must live first in total trust. Total trust. Total obedience and the total submission to the Lord. Maybe, just maybe, there are some other fathers like Brother Muddersill in the balcony who wants to join with me to say, you know what? As of today, our commitment is going to be for this generation of young men that we have. Our task is to teach them wisdom. My church has gone quiet. And so for my sons, Chris Anthony and Chris Brown, why do you look for me so funny? Our task is that our young men are to be taught wisdom. Wisdom says you are going to live in total obedience, total submission, and total trust in the God of the church of the living God. I wish I had somebody who would get happy with me, but that's fine. Come with me, church. So come back with verse number 5. He says, my son, I am begging you, keep these to your heart. Trust in the Lord. Are you ready now, church? Are you ready now, church? I gotta ask you to slow down with me. Can you do that? Slow down with me. That word, Lord, in the text is the Hebrew word Yahweh. Yahweh. And for some strange reason, I was led again to try and break it out. Do I have your permission, church? Okay. Now, don't forget that Yahweh is the most important Hebrew name for God. So holy was the name that the Hebrew did not even want to add vowels to it. Hey. So in fact, whenever you read it, there are only 4 letters. And there are those of us who follow some other churches and follow some other preachers, and you hear them say the name of God is Yod Het Vav He. Have you ever heard that? All the time. Come on, church. You hear it all the time. they say yod he vav he. What they are doing is citing the Hebrew letters yod he vav he. But that's not what the trouble is, church. The yod, which is the Y, carries a number of 10. Bear with me. What was the number it carries? 10. The he, which is the H, carries a total value of 5. The vav, which is the W, carries 6. And the he at the end carries another 5. So when you add yod, he, vav, he, you get 26. Watch. And 26, in the Hebrew, you are putting two letters together. You are putting a kaf, which is 20. I'm going to help you. And a vav, which is 6. Mm-hmm. The kaf is a hand. Hello, church. What is the kaf? A hand. And the vav is a nail. Oh, Lord, now, church. All right, let's go again. The kaf is a hand and the vav is a nail. And a nail, N-A-I-L. So let me go again, church. The kaf is a hand and the vav is a nail. Come back to the passage then. I have lost you a long time. So when the text says, trust the Lord, trust the one who has the number 26, for in that number 26, you have a hand that has been nailed. Come on, church of God. Come on, church. If thank you, Sister Nugent. There is a hand that has been named. It therefore means when he says, trust in the Lord, he is saying, trust in the one who has the power to save you. Trust in the one who has the power to spare you. Trust in the one that has the power to use you for his honor and for his glory. And I have turned up to church with my loudness, forgive me, because some trust horses and some trust chariots, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God, for the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run into it and they are saved. I have a news, some news for somebody. Your friends can't save you. Your family can't save you. Your father can't save you. Your mother can't save you. Your boyfriend can't save you. Your boss can't save you. Your neighbors can't save you. But I know somebody who can. His name is Jesus, for he was nailed to the cross. Come. Brother Tyrone, in the matter what go on, there's only one who can save us. His name is Jesus. Come on, church. In the matter what I go on downtown Kingston, there's only one person who can save us. His name is. I wish we had the time this morning. There's only one who can save us. His name is Jesus. There's only one who can spare us. His name is Jesus. There's only one who can use us. His name is Jesus. So come then with me. I ask you today to place your trust, because to place your trust suggests I am placing my confidence. I am placing my certainty. I'm placing my security in the one who can save me. Do I have a witness yet, church, that I came here this morning knowing that not everything is all right, but I still have faith in believing that I can place my confidence, I can place my certainty, I can place my surety in the one who stills the waters? Do I have yet a witness who can remind us about the troubles you've been in last week and last month and last year? But through all of my trials, through all of my testings, through all of my troubles, God has never left me. Come on, somebody. There are those who slam the door in my face. There are those who turn their backs upon me. There are those who walked away from me. But God, in his eternal wisdom, says, you can still trust me. Come on, somebody. The doors might be closed, yes. The help might be turned off. But God says, you can still trust me. And I want you to trust me, not when things are going well, but when times are dark. I want you to trust me, not when you have money in your pocket, but when you are as broke as a church mouse. I want you to trust me, not when your health is intact, but when you feel weak like a rat. I want you to trust me, not when you have everything you need, but when you know that everything is topsy-turvy. God says, that's when I can be God. God can only be God. So then God can only be God when some of our backs are against the wall. Brother Ellis, God can only be God when we can't see our way. You see, as long as we can buy food and clothes and put gas in the car, we are as proud as peacocks. There is no need to trust God. But you wait until the insurance is due. Come on, church. Come on, church. You just wait until the rubber hits the road. And you gotta say, Jesus, take the wheel. Come down with me. I need to leave three thoughts with you. I'm asking you to place your trust in the one who can save. And it means three things for me. And I'll get out of your way. My time is gone. Are you ready, church? Are you ready, church? One, placing our trust in God requires a total investment of our hearts. What the text says? Trust the Lord with all, church, thine heart. The beauty about the word heart, as used especially in the Old Testament scripture, that the word heart is never used to mean that organ that pumps blood around the body. In fact, the best rendition of that story, of that word heart, is the story of Samson and Delilah. How? When you read the story, Samson had to lie to her about what was the source of his strength. But she badgered him long enough, and the King James says that Samson told her his entire heart. Wow. The heart is not just an organ in the text that pumps blood. It's not just the mind, church. It is the intellect All right, I've lost you. That's why, new gentologically, I will always say, the most intelligent decision any man or woman can make is a surrendering of his or her life to the Lord. It is not a fly-by-night. It is an intelligent, intellectual decision that you have come to a consensus. You have come to the conclusion that there is a God and that this God is worthy to be worshipped. If you have not yet made that decision of your life, no matter what your CXC results look like, you still have a more important intellectual decision to make. Because that's why the scripture says, the fool says in his heart, come back with me. Trusting God requires a total investment of the heart. And because it is an intellectual decision, it offers us three words, and I leave them for your contemplation. What are the three words? The heart that is totally invested suggests my inspiration, my imagination, and my intention is either from God or towards God. Help us, Holy Spirit. My church, God, quieten me. I need to go back and leave. These people are vexed. Sister Dalberry, hear me. That when the heart is totally invested in God, when we have given over our minds to God, then our inspiration, our imagination, and our intention is always towards God. So guess what, church? Guess what, church? Guess what? Those of us who trust God don't have a Sunday life versus a Monday life. I know you'd have gone quiet on me. Those of us who trust God don't have a church life and a work life. Those of us who trust God don't have a choir life and a taxi life. Those of us who trust God don't have a pastor life, yes, and a neighbor life. Why? Because everything that we imagine, everything that we inspire to do, everything that we intend to do is of God and for God. Oh, I wish then in the East Queen Street Baptist Church somebody would say, I have no money, but my mind is made up, and I won't turn back, for I want to see my Jesus someday.
No,
please. Problem with church, you know, is because so often we have half made up minds for God. Is your mind fully made up yet? Have you fully made up your mind? Because if you have fully made up your mind, then you are totally invested. Why? Our intentions. Thank you, Sister Nugent. our imaginations and our inspiration is always either for God or towards God. Well, number two. Number two. Church is a total investment of the heart, but it is a total interruption of the personal faculties. I'm going to say it again. A total interruption, one is an investment, the other is an interruption of our personal faculty. Trust in the Lord. Total investment with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. Interruption of personal faculty. Church. All right, hold three words. You ready? Come on, East Green Street, you ready? Word number one. What did the Solomon mean when he said, lean not? Rely not? Rest not? Be propped up not by your own mind? Ready? Ready, church? Muscle and money. Run that again, Pastor. What is the interruption? Mind, muscle, and money. What do you mean by that, Pastor Nugent? I hear my sons in the balcony asking. You see, once our minds are well, church, we are bossier than a fly. But one of the things that I have learned, having married to a psychiatrist for the last 20 years, it's more than 20 now, I suspect that she has not yet fully sought me out. One of the things I've learned from being around a psychiatrist for so long is the fragility of the mind. Unlike other aspects of medicine, where the surgeon can cut out a part and you work well, the mind is such a delicate balance that very often when it goes, it's hard to come back, if ever come back. Hello, church? Isn't it true that enough people who have had a whole heap of intellect, forgive me, end up with Alzheimer's? Lord. Even some of them who curse church and said there is no God. And in our earlier stage, we used to say that them people who end up with Alzheimer's, I'm grateful for enlightenment, are people who turn their back upon God. That's how we learned it as youngsters. We never understood it as it is now. But come, church. The mind, come then with me. The muscle, which is the human strength. The word says, even the youth shall faint and grow weary, and young men shall utterly fall. COVID, which can't be seen with the naked eye, shut down the entire world for 2 years. And our money? I saw just this week something from NCB that says if you have some 20-pound notes and some 50-pound notes, come quickly, come deposit them. Because after a certain time this month, they are no longer of any value. Come, church. Come, church. Come, church. Come, church. East Queen Street. East Queen Street. We can't rely on the human mind. Not true? We can't rely on the human muscle. We can't rely on human money. But I hear the word of the Lord saying, but they, preach now, pastor, that wait upon the Lord, are you yet with me? Shall, I wish I had a church that would praise him, shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. I might not have the mind, nor do I have the muscle, nor I have the money, but I have one thing that you can't take away. I have Jesus, and you simply can't take it away from me. I might not be able to wear the kind of fashion you would like, but I still have Jesus. This church gone quiet on me to the body, you know. Sister Lewis, through many dangers, make me talk now, tires and sneers, we have already come. It was not by our mind, nor by our muscle, nor by our money, but it was by grace that brought you saved thus far. And grace will lead you on. Some of us might not get to 91, but we will tell them nonetheless, my mind is fixed on God, for he is the source of my strength. And he's the strength of my life. Somebody say, Pastor, you're gone too long. Let me just drop this one. I won't preach it long, Sister Latoya. My time gone. It is one, a total investment. Church? Two is a total interruption. And three, third and finally, and I'm done, it's a total inclusion. It's a total inclusion in one's personal future. What did the sixth verse say? In all thy ways. Verse 5 said it to you, know, trust in the Lord with all. And then verse 6 says, in all thy ways, acknowledge him. I heard a preacher once say that it is as if when you walk into a room, God is there, you must acknowledge him. God, that word acknowledge really means to know. It means to know. And to know means to be intimately aware of. Church? I. Zero again. Okay. In all thy doings, in all thy movements, in all thy maneuvering, know him. I close it this way. Somebody called me the other day and said, Pastor, you know, so-and-so has said so-and-so about me. I said to the person, well, it is clear that that person does not know you. Because had that person known who you are, the person would know that there are some things you would not do. You're gone quiet on me now. When you know who God is, you know what God would do. Jesus, help me. Me need to say it one more time for East Green Street. East Green Street, when you know who God is, you know what God will do. One more time for Sister Da Costa. Sister Da Costa, when you know who God is, you know what God will do. Come on, church. So if you know what God is, or who God is, you know he shall direct your path. I wish I had the time, but we gotta go. Which means as God direct your path, he is going to make your path straight. He is going to make your path smooth, and he is going to make your path sure. Do I have somebody yet who can understand this little word with me? When God is included in your future, then your path that was crooked will be made straight. Preach now, pastor. Then the rough place will be made smooth, and the unsure space will be made sure. Oh, I wish I had five persons who would agree with me by saying, before I knew who the Lord was, my life was topsy-turvy. But the moment I made that decision and I said, I will serve you because I love you, you have given life to me. I was nothing before you found me. You have given life to me. Heartaches and broken pieces, ruined lives are why you died on Calvary. Your touch is what I long for. You have given life to me. It is not yet perfect, but my ways have been straightened out. It might not yet be perfect, but my path is being smoothed out. Come on, church. It might not be perfect, but I'm sure in whom I have believed, like the apostle, and I am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have committed. So all I have stopped by church to declare, I need him, Sister Lewis, in my walking. I need him in my talking. Every minute of the day, give me Jesus, for he's my reason for living. He's my source and my survival. Every minute of the day, you give me Jesus. You can have the whole world, but give me Jesus. Though none go with me, yet still will I follow. I shall not turn back, for I not only need him now, but I need him in the future. I wish somebody could look at themselves and say, if you see me now, you think I look good. God still has a better future for me. Ah, God, oh Lord, help us, Holy Ghost. God, you are going to remove some stumbling blocks. God, you are going to remove some roadblocks. God, you are going to remove some setbacks. God, you are going to remove some disappointments. God, you are going to remove some trouble. God, you are going to remove some pain. God, you are going to remove some anxiety. Because I've seen a future in you. I've seen a future with you. And that future says straight ahead.
Ooh. I done. I'm finished, I promise you. My certainty, my confidence, my surety is the one who bore nails in his hand.
And therefore, that's the one who I will trust. It invites me to invest my entire heart. It challenges me to a life of total interruption of my personal faculties. And it allows me for a total inclusion in my future. I'm finished. It is unwise to lead a life without God as the leader. Amen. I like that. I didn't tell them to write that. I like that. Wisdom becomes elusive when the fear of God is not accompanying your achievements. Thank you, preacher. You preach a better sermon than me. In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, the solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. Our hymn of response. So we all stand.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in heaveless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on the cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live. There in the ground his body laid, light of the world by darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. In life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns
or calls me home,
here in the power of Christ I stand.
No power of hell,
from his hand, oh, till he returns.
Or calls me home, here in the power of Christ the Lamb.
The altar is open. The altar is open to someone to say, God, I will trust you. I will just leave my certainty upon you. The altar is open. That's all I'm going to say.
Till he returns.
In Christ alone. Verse 4. In Christ alone. Verse 4.
No guilt in life,
no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me.
From life's first cry to final breath,
Jesus commands my death. Destiny, no power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand till he returns
or calls me home.
Oh, here
in the power of Christ I'll stand. No power of hell, no scheme of man.
Till he returns
or calls me home, here in the power of Christ
I stand.
No power of hell, no scheme of man can never block me from his hand.
Till he returns
or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ, I'll stand.
I am trusting thee, Lord Jesus, trusting only thee. Trusting thee for full salvation,
great and free.
Can we sing one more verse? I am trusting thee.
I am trusting
thee for
pardon.
Yeah, at thy feet I bow
for thy
grace and tender mercy,
trusting now.
Hallelujah. I'm gonna pray. And as we prepare our hearts to pray, those of us who have come to the altar, it is not the time for us to look at the neighbor. It is not even the time to worry about what those who are in their seats are saying about me. I am here with you at the altar. For there shall be nothing between my soul and my Savior. God, I thank you. God, I thank you that a vessel as imperfect as this one, you can choose to use to speak to the hearts of your children. God, what I have heard from you, I have sought to be faithful in its impartation. But the rest really is up to you. So today, as we stand at this old-fashioned altar, we have come because so often our lives are challenged by the vicissitudes we encounter. Yes. And sometimes we become faithless in the midst of the difficulties. We become tired of fighting. Oh God. And we feel sometimes it is just the right time to let go. But God, in your mercy, you have sent us the words of Solomon again. Trust me. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Hallelujah. And lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, so that he can direct your path. God, because you have been our hope, we hold on to your promises. God, because you have been our strength, we hold on to your hand. And because you have been our light, we hold on, knowing that you shall walk us through the darkened times. God, for those who have come to this altar today, minded and mindful of their frailties, we have come with hands lifted up. And like Jabez, we are asking you, just rest your hand upon our heads and bless us. Woo! Bless me. Oh God, bless me. Oh Lord. Yeah. Bless me indeed. Enlarge my territory. I hear God, someone in the spirit crying, God, bless my family. Bless my children. Bless my household. Bless my offsprings. In the name of Jesus. God, we pray with that one who came to this altar with a heavy heart for a child or a grandchild. We pray for the one that has come to this altar with uncertainty in the back of the mind about what will happen this week. We pray for those who will head back to school beginning this week, uncertain. God, remind us that the starting point is the fear of the Lord. God, can you forgive us? Forgive us, Lord, where we have sinned, where we have gone astray, where we have taken your name for granted. And like the psalmist, create in us clean hearts. Renew your spirit. So shall my walk be close with God. A calm and a heavenly frame. A light that shines upon the road that leads me to the Lamb. God, in a special way, we pray with Sister Lewis, and we pray with her family. those that came down to the altar, those that are in their places. God, we pray that your hand of grace will be extended upon them, and that by your mercy, you will continue to bless them. So today, let God arise in his house. I wish I had somebody who would praise him. Come on, let God arise. In his house, let the Holy Spirit arise. So that where we are weak, we will be strengthened. In Jesus' name. And the church say, amen. Somebody give God a clap offering of praise. I beg you, if you are at this old-fashioned altar and you have not yet made Jesus the Lord of your life, if you have not yet made a commitment of your life to the Lord, today is a good day. Today is a great day to say yes to the Lord. Is there somebody at the altar who would like to say yes to Jesus? You're not a Christian, but you're at the altar. You want to say, God, I'm going to trust you with my life. Is there one such person? Is there one such person? One final time. Is there one such person? If there's no one, God bless you. Keep on trusting him. In Jesus' name, you may return to your seats. Hallelujah. Amen, church. Amen. Come on, East Queen Street, can we bless the Lord?
Hallelujah.
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 So, my family in Christ, we're going to move to the other aspect of our worship service, which is the communion aspect. We're going to invite the choir to lead us in our singing, while we, the deacons and myself, will begin to make preparation for that.
every hour.
Bless me now, my Savior. I come to thee. I need thee, oh, I need thee. Heads for a moment. Let's bow your heads with me for a moment. As we bow our heads, it is our time with God. Father of the world, you are the light within me. Lord of all creation, living in my heart. And I will praise you, Lord, regardless of all my blessings. You alone are worthy of my praise just because you are. Bowing before you, Lord, is a privilege, is an honor to worship at your throne. My chains are gone. Hallelujah. My chains are gone. I've been set free. My God and the Savior has ransomed me, and like a flood, his mercy came, unending love, amazing grace. God, we confess our faults, our failings, and our failures. We have come, God, praying that you will create in us clean hearts. And if there are things in our lives that has dishonored you, let it be done with your cleansing. Cleanse our hearts. Cleanse our minds. Cleanse our hands. Cleanse our entire being. Spirit of the living God, there is still a fountain filled with blood that's drawn from Emmanuel's vein, and the sinners plunge beneath the flood, lose all their guilt and their stain. This day, which is your day, we return to the precincts of your courts, saying, God, we have longed for sweet peace and for faith to increase, and we have earnestly and fervently prayed, but we cannot have rest nor be perfectly blessed until all on the altar is laid. So Lord, take us back to the altar. Drop us on the altar. And like Paul, we declare, we have become living sacrifices. Yes, 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 yes. Living sacrifices. Bless your name and bless your truth. In Jesus' name we pray. And the church saying, my brothers and sisters in Christ, if you have truly and earnestly repent of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors, resolve to lead a new life in the Lord, following his commandments and walking henceforth in his holy way, draw near with faith and come, take this sacrament to your growth and your comfort in grace. But we always remind ourselves that we do not come to the sacred table because we must, but because we may. Our coming is not a signal to the neighbor that we are righteous, but rather that we sincerely love the Lord and we are desirous of being his true disciples. We come not because we are strong, but because we are weak. Not because we have claim to heaven and all its rewards, but in our frailty and our sins, we stand in constant need of heaven's mercy and help. For what can wash away our sins? Come on, church. What can wash away our sins? And what can make us whole again?
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
So therefore, by God's grace, we have come, assured that there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ. And old time people would say, if your conscience set you free, pray on. Our Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, having called his disciples to the upper room, he took bread. And when he took bread, he blessed it, broke it, and offered to the disciples, saying, this is my body, which is broken for you. As often as you eat, do so in memory of me. And when the supper had ended, he took the fourth and final cup from the table and declared to them, this cup is the New Testament sealed with my blood. As often as you drink, do so in memory of me. For whenever we eat this bread and drink from the cup, we show forth the Lord's death until he comes. Now, in the name of Jesus, who is our Christ, who instituted the sacrament of his broken body and shed blood and set them apart to the use he has appointed, just as how we broke and gave thanks, Deacon Melody Williams will offer a prayer of thanks for the bread, and Deacon Irvin Sutherland a prayer of thanks for the cup. Let us pray.
Heavenly Father, Holy God, we come before you today giving thanks and praise for all that you have done for us. Father, we have gathered here now to partake of the Lord's Supper, Holy Communion. Lord, the bread has been presented, has been prepared now. Lord, we ask a special blessing on it. As we eat it, Lord, help us to remember your sacrifice on the cross, your body given up for us. And Lord, as we remember, help us to give thanks. Father, we praise you. Bless, O Lord, this bread. And help us, O Lord, to continue to praise you and trust you with all our hearts. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
Our Father,
we have come to your table, for whosoever will may come. We do so, Lord, with a desire to totally trust you, totally obey you, and be in total submission to you. For we acknowledge your sovereignty and supremacy over all things, and the surety we have in you. There is this fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's vein, and those who plunge beneath it lose all their guilty stains. So we present, Lord, your cup, the cup of the new covenant in your blood. We ask you to not only bless it, but sanctify it. We ask you, Lord, to remind us that we have this wonderful relationship with you. And that's why we can come to this table. For it's by grace we have been saved through faith, and this not of ourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. And so we bow before you in humble adoration, thanksgiving, and praise for permitting us to participate in this cup. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
And the church say amen. Amen. Here at East Queen Street, we are one family. So, once you are a member of the household of faith, not a member of East Queen Street, a member of the body of Christ, even if your membership is not at East Queen Street, you are free to participate with us once you have named the name of the Lord. Lord, I wish somebody would have said amen. Amen. Mm-hmm. Because all are we are one. Not true? So whether you're uptown, downtown, out of town, round town, at the table of the Lord, Bishop Blair would say, the ground is level at the foot of the cross. So our deacons are going to be serving. And after each one has been served, all of us will partake together. Is that okay? Amen? Amen. And so the choir will continue to lead us in our singing. The next song, Wonderful, Merciful Savior.
Before your throne.
that we praise. You are the one we adore. You give the healing and grace. Our hearts always hunger for. Oh, our hearts always hunger for. You are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You give healing and grace. Our hearts always hunger for. Oh, our hearts always hunger. You are the one. One more time we go. You are the one that we praise. At all. Well, you give the healing and grace. Hearts always hunger for. Oh, hearts always hunger. There is a Redeemer. Come on, church. Precious Lamb of God, Messiah, Holy One. Thank you, O my Father, for giving us your Son
and leaving your Spirit. King of my life, I crown thee now. Thine thy glory be. Thine shall thy glory be, lest I forget. Thy thorn crown brow, lead me to Calvary. Is there someone we yet to be served? Just raise your hand. King of
my life
I crown
thee. Come on, church.
Thine
shall thy glory be. Lest I forget
thy
full crown, brow.
Lead me to Calvary.
So we sing, oh. Forget thy love for me.
Lead me to Calvary.
Show
me the tomb where thou wast laid. Tenderly mourned and wept. Angels in robes of light arrayed guarded thee whilst thou slept.
Let's go, lest I forget.
Lest
forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thy agony, lest I forget thy love for me. Cross, I shall never forget. Calvary's cross,
I shall never forget.
Calvary's cross, I shall never forget.
because he first loved me.
Calvary's cross,
Calvary's cross, I shall never forget.
Oh,
Calvary's cross,
I shall never forget.
Calvary's cross, I shall never forget. Because he first loved me.
So my family in Christ, today God has given us the opportunity to share at his table. So come. Take this bread. Jesus said, it is my body. For you, it has been broken. Can we now eat together with thanksgiving in our hearts? Say yes, Lord,
yes, to your will and to your way.
Yes, Lord, yes,
I will trust you and obey.
When your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart and my answer, sing it with me one more time. Let's go.
I'll say yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your
Holy Ghost.
I'll say yes, Lord, yes, and I will trust you and obey.
When your spirit
speaks to me with my whole heart,
and my answer will be yes. Come on, East Queen Street, one more time. I say yes, Lord, to your will. I say yes,
Lord, yes,
I will trust you when your speaks to me with my come on, church, and my
answer
will be yes,
Lord, yes,
when your spirit speaks, and when your speaks to me with my
whole heart,
my answer will be,
and my answer will be
yes, Lord, yes, when your spirit, and when your
spirit
speaks, I'll say with my whole heart, hallelujah, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes. Hallelujah. The cup symbolizing the shed blood of Christ. Can we together drink with thanksgiving in our hearts? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can we praise the Lord one more time? Somebody just lift a hand in the sanctuary and just give God praise. By the grace of God, I am saved. Can we sing that? By the grace of God, I am saved. By the grace of God, I am saved. Glory, glory. Lord, hallelujah. By the grace of God, I am saved. I have been. Oh, I am saved by the grace, by the grace of God. I am saved. Glory. Come on, church. Glory, glory. Oh Lord, hallelujah. Oh, by the grace of God, I am saved. I am saved. I've been walking. I have been walking hand in hand with Jesus. That's why I'm saved. I have been hand in hand with Jesus. That's why I'm saved. Glory, glory, glory. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, by the grace. I say now, I am. Forgive me, church. This is not young people music. This is old people music. That's why our deacon on piano is having a hard time. He's young. Come on, church. You know, we know one time when there was not so much gospel music on radio. Ah, Brother Gary, I dating, you know. And Grace Trillers used to. Oh, yeah. Come on, church. Come on. Some of the music that kept us. By the grace of God, yeah, I am saved. Do I have a witness in the house yet? Oh, by the grace of God, I am saved. Glory, 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 glory. Oh, hallelujah. By the grace of God, by the grace of God. Stand with me if you can. I am saved. For I have been walking hand in hand with Jesus. That's why I'm saved. I have been walking. Do I have a witness yet? Oh, that's why I'm saved. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Glory,
glory.
Hey, God.
Glory.
Hey, Lord, hallelujah. Sing, somebody. By the grace, I am saved. By the grace. It's by God's grace I am saved. I am saved by the grace. By the grace. I am saved. Glory. By the grace. Come on, church.
Come on, Pastor.
Come on, church. Church almost finished. Church almost done. I'm releasing you early today. Come on, church. I wish I could find 20 people who are willing to sing with me. Come on, church. Yeah. No, hallelujah. By the grace of God. I don't know about you, but I am saved. Come on, somebody, tell yourself I can testify. By the grace of God. I don't know about you. God, but I am saved. Somebody give God a praise. Come on, East Queen Street, somebody give God a praise. You see, some people don't know what hell we have gone through. Somebody give God a praise. Come on, Deacon. Give God praise. They don't know where we are come from, but give God praise. Yeah, hallelujah. Somebody give him praise. Worship him in the house of God. Magnify. My God. Hey, hallelujah. Mighty God, hallelujah. Out of your bellies shall flow rivers of living waters. Yes, let the praises rise from the inside. Oh God, hallelujah. I gotta release you. I gotta let you go. At some point today I'm gonna let you go under the Holy Ghost. But let me just, I know my deacons will support me. Friends, that I'm going to ask us on third Sunday when we're coming, walk with a special offering. Walk with a special offering on third Sunday. The East Queen Street Baptist Church is going to be making some kind of a gesture to the family of the two girls that were washed away in St. Mary and to the family that lost their two sons in Clarendon. Don't worry, if you fire me, God will hire me. But as the Christian community, we're going to stand. We still have not decided how we're going to be dealing with our friends next door. We have not lost them. We have not lost sight of them. More will be said about what we're going to be doing on James Street. But we have, as a congregation, every father, every mother, you know, we will have to send a signal that East Queen Street is conscious about what's happening with our family members outside of East Queen Street. You're in agreement with me? You're in agreement with me? Praise God, praise God, praise God. Let's pray. Can you just, if you can, just give your neighbor an elbow and say, neighbor, come on, neighbor, the Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his light and his countenance upon you and give you peace. And give you peace. And give you peace. In Jesus' name. And the church of God say.
Amen.
And the church say.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh Lord, we didn't say the covenant, but forgive me. Let's turn to the covenant quickly. We haven't done so in a while. Let's turn to our church covenant and let's covenant together. And then we have the written benediction, then we can go. Verse 1 and verse 2. Church covenant, let's go. Having been led, as we believe, by the Spirit of God, to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior and on profession of our faith, having been baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, we now, in the presence of God and this assembly, most solemnly and joyfully enter into covenant with one another as one body in Christ. We, therefore, by the aid of the Holy Spirit, to walk together in Christian love, to strive for the advancement of this church in knowledge, holiness, and comfort, to promote its prosperity and spirituality, to sustain its worship, ordinances, discipline, and doctrines, to the support of the ministry, the relief of the poor through all nations, engaged to maintain family and secret devotions, to religiously educate our children, to seek the salvation of our kindred and acquaintances, to walk circumspectly in the world, in our dealings, faithful in our engagement, an exemplar in our deportment, to avoid all tattling, backbiting, and excessive anger, to abstain from the sale of and use of intoxicating drinks as a beverage, to be zealous in our efforts to advance the kingdom of our Savior, to further engage to watch over one another in brotherly and sisterly love, to remember one another in prayer, one another in sickness and distress, to cultivate Christian sympathy in feeling and Christian courtesy in speech, to slow to take offense, but always ready for reconciliation, and mindful of the rules of our Savior, to secure it without delay. We moreover engage that when we remove from this place, we will as soon as possible unite with where we can carry out the spirit of this covenant of God's word. The church of God say,
amen.
And there's another benediction. I don't know. We did one already. So we'll just sing the first and last verses of the hymn, Will Your Anchor Hold? And we'll go into the world. Will your anchor hold in the storm of life when the clouds unfold their wings of strife, when the strong tides lift and the cables strain? Will your anchor drift or firm remain? We have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure, while the billows roll, they are fastened to the rock which cannot move.